It's Cinco de Mayo, and when you think Cinco de Mayo, you think margaritas, right? Well, as much as I do love a delicious margarita, I'm going to shake things up a little bit at my fiesta by serving the Devil's Garden. If your Spanish is a little rusty, Cinco de Mayo means May 5th. And despite what many people think, Cinco de Mayo is not Mexican Independence Day. It actually celebrates the Mexican victory over the French at the Battle of Puebla on May 5th, 1862. Mexican Independence Day actually occurred 50 years prior to the Battle of Puebla and is celebrated on September 16th. In fact, in Mexico, Cinco de Mayo isn't nearly as big a deal as Mexican Independence Day. But you know where it is a big deal? Right here in the US of A. The largest Cinco de Mayo party in the world takes place in Los Angeles, California. Since that's where we are, let's make our cocktail. To make the Devil's Garden, we'll need 1.5 ounces of Reposado tequila, 1/2 ounce of chipotle-infused mezcal, 1/2 ounce of chinar, a dash of Angostura bitters, 3/4 ounces of agave nectar, 3/4 ounces of lime juice, and 4 to 6 mint leaves. I made our chipotle-infused mezcal last night. Here's what I used. 1 dried chipotle pepper and 1 cup of mezcal. I toasted 1 dried chipotle in a pan over high heat until it began to smoke a little. Then I removed it from the heat. I placed the pepper in a jar, added 1 cup of mezcal, tightly covered the jar, and let it sit overnight. Now, in an ice shaker, combine mint, lime juice, agave, chinar, mezcal, and tequila. For this cocktail, we want to be sure to use a reposado tequila. Reposado means that tequila has been rested in oak barrels for a period of about 2 to 12 months. Some companies will char the wood to give the tequila a smoky flavor, while other companies will use barrels that have been previously used for wine or whiskey to give the tequila a more complex flavor. We'll shake our mixture and strain it into an iced coupe. This drink is really complex, and you can feel the heat from the pepper. It's really nice. Until next time, I'm going to leave you with a toast that I learned from my mother. Arriba, abajo, al centro, adentro. Cheers. The Social Drinker is taking a little break, but be sure to subscribe so that you know when we're back with more fun facts and delicious drink recipes. Cheers.